The Philippines entered 2023 with some pressing concerns still left unaddressed. Inflation remains high, quality of jobs is still declining, and prices of agricultural products are soaring. With the passage of the 2023 spending plan, government is confident of fulfilling its target of uplifting the lives of Filipinos. Infrastructure, agriculture, and healthcare are among the sectors that saw major budget increases this year. But will these even make a dent as economic challenges abound? To help us make more sense of the 5.3 trillion peso national budget for 2023, we're now joined by former Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Ernesto Pernia. So I'd like to start out by asking your assessment of the 2023 budget. It's touted as the administration's agenda for prosperity. What is your reaction to this? Do you agree?
Well, it's only 4% higher than the budget last year. So, and moreover, inflation has been rather quite strong last year. So in terms of real budget, real value of the budget, it's not really that great a budget.
But that said, I think even though it's only up by 4 or 5%, they will be increasing the allocation for agriculture by quite a bit. What can you say about that?
Well, that's right, because agriculture is really the most laggard among the sectors of the economy. That's very critical. That's a very critical sector because it has to do with food, and we are really, running way behind our Asian neighbors in terms of food production. So we have to import a lot. You know, that costs a lot of money, and it's not good that an agricultural country like the Philippines would be importing so much compared with Vietnam, with Thailand, with Malaysia, with Indonesia, for example.
So do you think the increase in budget for agriculture is enough already to help the sector?
I would give agriculture more funding because, as I've said, we want to move faster ahead in terms of development of the agricultural sector, and so that also we are not going to be dependent on imports, for the longest for the coming years. So yeah, that I think agriculture would need some more budget, a bit higher budget.
What about your views on the higher spending on, say, education and even transportation?
Yes, for education, I think education is the highest in terms of budgetary allocation. But the thing is, we have a huge school-going population. Our education system is not in good shape. It is in crisis, actually, and we really need to spend more in terms of teacher training, in terms of making our school children ready for school, meaning providing with them with nutrition, to be able to learn adequately in terms of what they are undergoing in school. And even early childhood development is also very important because we want to reduce stunting, which is something like 30% of children 0 to 5 years of age. And then the health sector is also a sector that needs additional funding. The healthcare workers, as you know, until now, many of them haven't received their emoluments. So we have these issues that deserve attention from the administration, from the government.
What sectors do you think can we spend less on so that we can allocate more towards those particular sectors that really need a lot?
I would, we are putting in something like more than a trillion, 1.3 or 1.2 trillion for infrastructure. But then much of this funding for infrastructure can be shifted to, as I've said, education, health sector, and agriculture, because we are pushing for public-private partnership. Public-private partnership will be a relief to the budget in terms of financing them, because the funds will be coming from the private sector. The government is just making it easy for them to get involved in developing projects or in repairing projects for the country.
So finally, for my last question, I'd like to ask for your views on the budget deficit and the debt level. So I think for this year, the government is going to start to reduce the deficit and the debt level. So is this something that we can further delay? Or, should we focus our attention to reducing the deficit and the debt levels?
Well, we have to be cautious. Yeah, we really have to take care of the debt, because remember that the target was not to exceed 60% of GDP for our debt, but we have exceeded that already. So we should try to trim it back to below 60%, at least for the first, for this year. So it's a very careful balancing act that the government has to do.
So that said, are we at risk? Do you think are we at risk of a credit ratings downgrade in 2023?
Well, if we are not able to handle the, at least take out 3% of the 63% percent debt to GDP ratio, then I think it's not going to be a good signal for credit rating agencies.
Okay, so with that, thank you very much for your thoughts, Mr. Pernia. I look forward to a better budget in the next few years, that we allocate more towards those important sectors, as you've discussed, like agriculture and education. Thank you so much.